So hello students, already you have learned about the principle that is involved in the dichromatic titration. Now let's see the procedure that is behind it. Now for that it includes three steps. First one is the preparation of the standard ferrous ammonium salt solution. Second one is standardization of potassium dichromate solution. The last one is estimation of iron. So the first step, as I told you, that we need to prepare standard ferrous ammonium salt solution. In order to prepare, first of all, we need to weigh the given sample of ferrous ammonium salt in the weighing bottle. So now let's see, I'm doing this. First one is the weight of the bottle. It's given as 4.89. Now that's what? The weight of the weighing bottle with ferrous ammonium salt. This is with the salt, students. So it is 4.89 grams. Now, immediately transfer this particular sample into the standard flask, and then with the help of funnel. After you transfer this one, is this empty? This is not empty, isn't it? Because this has some amount of salt in it. That's the reason. In order to know how much amount of salt has been transferred, you need to know the weight of this bottle after you transfer. So let me write weight of the bottle after transferring the salt. Now that will be, let me see the weight. This is 4.22. You can see, all of you, 4.22. Now 4.22 grams is the weight. Now how do we get the weight of the salt? So that will be weight of the salt, that is weight of ferrous ammonium salt, is given by the formula, that is W1 minus W2, that is 4.85 minus 4.22 grams. So you all know the formula of normality. Normality is weight of the salt by its equivalent weight, that is 392 into 1000. And you can see the students, all of you can see, this is 100 ml flask. Can you see this one? Okay, this one is 100 ml flask. So this is 100 ml. Now you can see the weight of here, 4.85 minus 4.22 by 392 into 10. So whatever the answer you get, it is in, this is the concentration of ferrous ammonium salt solution. Right, this completes the first step, that is preparation of FAS salt solution. Now next one is, all these calculations you can do it. Now what you need to do is, this is what is called as wash bottle, which contains distilled water. So all of you be careful that you don't add tap water into it. You have to add only distilled water. So now this, you transfer little amount of distilled water, wash the walls of the funnel, because some amount of salt might be sticking to the walls. That's the reason, please wash even, so that the whole amount of the salt goes into the standard flask. After you remove this funnel, what you do is add little amount of water and you shake it thoroughly. Shake it thoroughly, see that the whole salt gets dissolved into the water. And after you dissolve this water, here the main important thing is you need to add sulfuric acid here. Why should you add sulfuric acid here? Because ferrous ammonium salt, it undergoes hydrolysis readily and forms ferrous hydroxide precipitate. So in order to prevent the hydrolysis and see that it doesn't undergo further oxidation, what we need to do is, we need to add few drops of concentrated sulfuric acid. So this is what is concentrated sulfuric acid. You can add dilute sulfuric acid also. Also you can even add the concentrated sulfuric acid. Okay. Now you can add 3 to 4 drops of concentrated sulfuric acid. So what are we adding for? This sulfuric acid prevents the hydrolysis of FAS salt solution and see that it doesn't undergo further oxidation. This is very, very important question for your viva. So now after you have added sulfuric acid, now continue adding distilled water. And distilled water you have to add till it reaches the mark. There will be a mark in the standard flask which shows that it is 100 ml. So now you all can see, students, there is a level here. So after you add distilled water for some time, the last part what you need to do is see that you do not over add this water, otherwise it will not be, it becomes diluted. So the last part of this water, you need to take the pipette and then add this little water drop by drop so that it reaches the exact level that is marked in the standard flask. And see that the lower level of the solution touches the line. For any colorless solution, we add in such a way that the lower level of this solution exactly touches the mark. And after you make the solution, shake it thoroughly and put it and cover it with a lid. So this is how you make the standard solution of ferrous ammonium salt solution. Thank you. Right, students. You are done with the first one, that is preparation of standard FAS solution. Now next one we need to do is standardization of potassium dichromate solution. So you all know that in your intermediate classes you have handled with burettes, pipette, conical flask. So this is all nothing new. So for this I am taking the first apparatus, that is burette. Any apparatus, understand one thing is you need to wash it with a tap water and then add little amount of distilled water and throw it away. This is what is called as rinsing. So first clean it with the tap water, then rinse it with the distilled water. I am showing you the rinsing part with the help of dichromate solution. See, you are adding little amount of dichromate solution and then you have to just do this way. This is what is called as rinsing. And see that little amount of dichromate solution also passes through the nozzle and throw it off. This is what is called as rinsing with the solution that you are going to fill. Finally, what you need to do is fill it up with this solution. While you are filling, please be careful that you do not put in the straight fashion. Put it in a slanting manner and then fill the burette with potassium dichromate solution. And see that it exactly comes to zero. There's a level zero that is marked over here. So exactly till zero. And see that it is not open. And there are no blocks or no gaps over here. And there is... Now clamp it. Yes. Now fill it with excess amount of solution. And finally, see that exactly it is brought to zero. That is, there is a level that is marked in the burette. See that exactly. Now see, students, all of you can see that it is exactly to the zero that is marked on the burette. After you fill it up, you clamp it to the stand, burette stand. Right. Now after you have filled this burette with our solution, that is potassium dichromate is acting as a link solution here. So standardization part we are doing. For that I have clamped it. Now next one is, this is what is called a standard solution. The solution is taken in the standard solution. So flask. Now what you do is, this is your conical flask. As I already told you that every flask should be, every apparatus should be washed clean with your water, tap water. Next, this is your pipette, students. The same procedure goes for this apparatus too. Wash it with the tap water. Then you can rinse it with the potassium dichromate solution. And then rinse it with ferrous ammonium salt solution, because you are taking this solution into the conical flask. And now you take 20 ml of, don't blow air into it, put it in the slanting manner. And take 20 ml of ferrous ammonium salt solution into it. So now when you take an extra dose of the solution, you can see that, please don't hold it with your thumb. Hold it with your forefinger. Right, so this, you can see that exactly it has gone up slightly. I am relieving the pressure so that it comes down. And now exact 20 ml of ferrous ammonium salt solution is taken into the conical flask. And relieve your forefinger, the whole solution goes to it. After you feel that everything has gone into the conical flask, give a small tap into it so that the entire solution falls into the flask. Now I have taken this solution here. What should I do with the next one? Since it is a redox titration, what you are doing is, you are taking your sulfuric acid. As I already told you that sulfuric acid mixture you are taking labanum. Now, potassium dichromate solution is also another example of oxidizing agent like your potassium permanganate, but it is not as powerful as potassium permanganate. So that's the reason why it requires another external indicator. Now to this, after you have added ferrous ammonium salt solution into the conical flask, next thing is, should we add indicator or not? In potassium permanganate, in permanganometry, you have not added because it acted as self-indicator. But this potassium dichromate solution needs external indicator because this is not as powerful oxidizing agent as that of potassium permanganate, and this is not giving yellow color. That's the reason what we are doing is we are using external indicator, and the indicator that we are using in this titration is diphenylamine indicator. So you add 3 to 4 drops of diphenylamine indicator. This is 1, 2, 3, 4 drops of diphenylamine indicator, and along with diphenylamine indicator you are also adding 1 full test tube or 10 ml of acid mixture. This acid mixture consists of sulfuric acid and phosphoric acid. You all know why are we adding sulfuric acid. Sulfuric acid releases nascent oxygen which brings about the oxidation of ferrous, that is from +2 to +3. And phosphoric acid, why are we doing this? Because diphenylamine indicator has an electrode potential of 0.78, that should be in the potential series of 2 reduction reactions, but it is not happening. And also one more thing is, when Fe plus 2 gets oxidized to Fe plus 3, that also may interfere and bring about the oxidation of diphenylamine indicator. So to prevent that, what we are doing is we are adding a syrup of phosphoric acid. So finally, in this, what are we adding? We are taking the required amount, that is 20 ml of ferrous ammonium salt solution. We are taking 3 to 4 drops of diphenylamine indicator. And we are taking the mixture, acid mixture of sulfuric and phosphoric acid. So sulfuric acid to prevent, that is to provide the acid medium to it, and phosphoric acid to see that it does not interfere in the oxidation of diphenylamine indicator. Now after you have added all these three, now let's see the how actually color changes. Hold your conical flask with your right hand and the nozzle of the burette with the left hand, and add drop by drop and see, and turn it and shake the flask and see that what happens here. So initially you don't have any change in the color, it is colorless, but what happens is after some time you are able to see a green colored formation. That's what I told you, you are not able to see yellow color. So that's the reason you are adding external indicator. Can you see a light green color that is formed here? It is coming out. So slowly you can actually, yeah, this is a white tile there which helps you to identify the change in the color. Now shake it thoroughly. Every drop you add, please see that you shake it thoroughly. And then you will be getting, let's see what happens. So continuously shake it, don't run tap over it, or don't open it continuously into it. You are able to see a green colored solution. So this green color confirms the formation of chromium in +3 oxidation state. So Cr +3 confirms the formation. Green color formation is because of the formation of Cr plus 3. Now continue adding potassium dichromate after you get green color. Let's see what happens. What is the final end point? So continuously you add, you are able to see a tinge of violet blue that is coming along with the green color. That means green is not the color that is formed at the end point. So finally you are going to get one more color. You can see that now, yes, you can see this is the violet blue color formed. This confirms the oxidation of diphenylamine to diphenylbenzidine. So chromium undergoes reduction from +6 to +3, and oxidation is diphenylamine to diphenylbenzidine. So this is what is the reduction reaction that is formed. And violet blue color you can actually see from the bottom of the conical flask, which you can see exactly clearly. So this is the final endpoint, that is forms rules. Okay, this confirms that your titration has been completed using diphenylamide indicator.